Hello everyone, this is Floyd again, and this is part 3. Yeah, part 3. And I just connected this. See this thing? There's a peg right there, and I made a hole. Just in this one. So I can go through here. And the problem is, with this one, you cannot turn it. Think if the car's gonna turn it. This literally turns with it. This is just a base idea for a little bit, just a few inches longer. As you can see where the wheels is gonna go, the stamps is gonna go. But these, I'm gonna make sure they come out of the trailer, not slide in. And just go up, slide, put over here, like that, like that. Which is a perfect size for this transformer. And basically, those two, those are for this one. Disconnect and peg it. And if you're wondering why I don't have the stats, because they're stupid. They really are. I prefer him. He's much better without them. Besides, they're right here. Instead of having them turn up, same thing with my Optimus. What's the point? You could have done an improvement on the stacks too. What you could have done is make them shrink when he's a robot. And when he comes to cab, make him big. Oh well. Guess that's asking a little bit too much, is it? And you got some transformers in there, so I'll just use this one. The first classic car that I made. Well, yeah. First one I did for my classic Optimus Prime. I think this is from a Rambo or G.I. Joe 6-wheel. Military car, something. There he is. He goes into this. I'm just gonna kind of take it like this, turn that way, back. And this slides. Just gonna go like this. Slide. The cars open to base mode, sort of. That does not move. These were just ideas. I never came. Now, for the grand plan, which will be in part 4.